I'm accomplishing something for me. What's stopping you from being the guy that goes home and changes your life?
It's not easy to come in here and kick shit out of yourself.
I was a failure.
I'm gonna change my life.
Couch potato, Gary Roberts, you are dead.
That's just a warm up, dude. Fucking man. It never gets easier, man.
Am I interrupting something, gentlemen?
Wow, that was the hardest workout I've ever had.
Well, I'm actually contemplating suicide.
I would love to talk about sex. Hey, you look more doable.
You're three steps away. Don't stop yet. Come on, work until the time is up.
I was offered sex.
You get 2 minutes rest afterwards. Don't give me that. Jumping over like this? Bullshit.
I don't want to see any of this crap.
And every rep counts.
I'm going to start working on myself. I'm going to change me. And let's see if other shit comes together. Who am I being?
Yeah.
Come on. Hardest one yet, buddy. I have been CrossFitting now for 3 months.
And what inspires you to go to a seminar?
It's so funny because I look back at 3 months ago and I barely knew what CrossFit was. And now here, I'm thirsting for knowledge. I want to know more. I never even begin to understand that I would be this interested in mastering my fitness and what my personal capabilities are. I have the opportunity to take CrossFit to the next level, to take my personal, what is my potential? How far can I go with this? I don't even know yet, but I know that just reading over the training guide, my brain is already opening. Like, I didn't know someone said, make sure your back has full extension. I didn't know what that meant. Or when I was doing a deadlift and my knees were buckling in and they said, don't do that. I didn't understand why not to do that. Just by reading the training guide, I'm like, oh, okay, I get what they're talking about. So tomorrow, I get the opportunity to be bombarded with world-class fitness knowledge. And I'm so excited. I mean, I've never been this excited about fitness. I don't know what's going on. I've been asked 25 times, what is CrossFit? I figured out CrossFit, to me, it's a blueprint. It's an absolute map to the fountain of youth. Seriously, like when I was reading the level one training guide and it says, hey, there's the only difference between the needs of an Olympic athlete and your grandparents, you know, differ just by a degree. And I mean, that just, everyone says I look 20, 25 years younger. The comments that I've gotten in the last 2 weeks, I just completely transformation, a totally different person. You know, and I'd forgotten that I was inside here, and I'm just so happy to have found myself again. Thanks to CrossFit. I mean, I was overweight, I was out of shape, my confidence was shot. I mean, I don't even believe it. When people are saying, what happened to you? I'm not quite sure how it happened. I just knew I was given this unique opportunity and I'm gonna work hard to do it. I remember the first feeling when I walked in the gym and they said do some leg kicks and I felt awkward, I was nervous. I felt like people were staring at me and I was trying to do a pull-up. I just felt like my gut was hanging out like 2 feet under my shirt and I was so embarrassed. And it was just like, oh my God, what am I doing? I'm out of my element. This is not my place. I shouldn't be here. And now, when I walk in anywhere, I'm just like, I feel good. My chest is high. My shoulders are back. I want to be challenged.
3 months ago when I asked you about exercise, you said you hadn't exercised in 20 years. How important is physical training to Gary Roberts today?
Here is how important training is to me today. It is a core necessity. Like when the first was mentioned how much it would cost to go to a CrossFit gym, that was like a deterrent in my mind about whether I would do this or not. Now, like That would go before a car payment and rent. That's an absolute necessity. That would be the biggest investment in myself, was to keep that up, keep that energy, keep being a part of that community. Like, if I do not move or sweat in a 24-hour period, I feel like, I'm like, okay, I gotta do something. Like last night, I was packing and just randomly dropped down 25 push-ups. Just had to feel it. I just had to feel the firing in my muscles. It's amazing, because 3 months ago, I said maybe should do some push-ups, and I would be, F that. Now it's a complete change. It absolutely is. ID, embarrassing. Let's look at that first ID photo.
How many pounds ago was this?
What's the weight on there?
270.
Wow.
That's really cool.
I'm nervous. I don't think, I've been in my gym, and then I went to the Portland gym, so I've only been to two CrossFit gyms, and I don't know, looking around, there's a lot of concentration. There's a lot of elite fitness right here, and concentration, that's a little overwhelming. I'm a little nervous.
Show of hands, please, if CrossFit has had a profound impact on you and your life. Amazing, right? For squat, the first movement we go over today, air squat. It is a beautiful symphony of movement, center of mass, all the way down, all the way up, crease it below the knee. It's beautiful. It's amazing. Functional movements move in a wave of contraction that starts by rocking out the core and radiates out to the extremity. So core to extremity is, if you push yourself harder than it is that you want to go, you will get more from that workout. CrossFit is a broad, general, and inclusive fitness program designed to raise your GPP, general physical preparedness, you've heard that before, to raise your GPP to a level from which you can blast off and potentiate any type of thing, endeavor, sport that you want to do. The blueprint of your failure is written within your program.
I like that guy. Todd, he's... No. Well spoken, descriptive. I love the analogies.
Now put your toes on. Let's go to your toes. Right, so we're playing with our body weight. When we're doing a squat, I want you to have the whole foot on the ground. But if you're newer to squats, I'm okay if you pull your toes up just so you can feel what it's like to get back in the heels, because I want to be weighted through my heels. Does that make sense, folks?
Bar back a little bit, Jeff. Half squat and down.
Better, Gary. Push up hard, flex your lats, and stand.
Push press and the push jerk. Cool thing about all three of these movements is that setup position and the finish position is the exact same for all three of them. In order to know which one you're doing, you've got to see what happens in the middle, okay? And then working your way down, elbows are going to be slightly in front of the bar, and if you're looking from the front or from the sides, really what you're shooting for is vertical forearms, because that's the path that the bar is going to take. Squeeze your face back out of the way of the bar, and then press the bar straight up overhead to lock out. She's got to get her face back out of the way, because we want that bar to go straight up overhead and then she presses the bar straight overhead to that lockout position. And that's gonna get the bar in the position that we want it to be. When you get the bar forward of the frontal plane that way, they get forward here, and you tell them, because normally the reason somebody's here is because their shoulders are ridiculously tight, so you tell them to pull the bar back overhead, and they do this. And it's over her heels, right? It's actually a little bit forward. There we go. So now she's like, yeah, it's over my feet, right? Well, yeah, but what have we done? We've surrendered that midline. So you've got to play this game of tighten the stomach up, pull the shoulders back, or pull the bar back, tighten the stomach up, pull the bar back, tighten the stomach up, and just work back and forth until you get them here into this position where the bar is directly overhead and that midline is nice and tight. Dip.
Seminar
so far?
10, 11, 12. It's very informative. I feel like in 3 months, I've been given a puzzle piece here and there, but still kind of not understood the full picture. This really helped kind of, you know, if you're putting together a puzzle and you got like everything around, but you still can't figure out what it is, and then it takes one piece just to see it. I feel like that's what today has been. It's kind of like glued many things together, kind of tied things together where I'm like, oh, like if I had blurry vision and I finally got glasses, I can now see it. Ah, that's what they were talking about. That's what they were talking about. So yeah, taking my fitness to this next level, I feel like the next WOD I'll go to, I'll be able to apply. I already know how I'm gonna apply something during the Fran that I didn't know yesterday. So amazing. Definition of fitness. I like it. Start. Form goes to shit, man. It just leaves this on a cliffhanger. I gotta do that shit again. I gotta make up for that. I can't believe how hard it gets after the first 10. First 10, I feel like freaking King Kong, right? I just know no matter what gains I've made in the last 3 months, this is only chapter one of a 100 chapter book. I've only begun to tap into my unlimited potential. He just said, what is CrossFit? Now, I really didn't know how to answer. I just said, man, it's the blueprint to, the ultimate fitness. I don't understand how the world doesn't be studying this book inside and out, left and right, forward and backwards. It should be prescribed in schools. It's a sad statement to our education system that I had to come here. He just got hit by Fran. That bitch just slapped us upside the head.